Today's show is pre-recorded.
Y'all know what time it is.
Y'all don't know, y'all better act somebody.
Hat on, hat on, suit on, suit on, looking like the Dapper Dawn, giving a microphone, dress like the $1 million, bumps things in its cuffs. Mm-hmm. Y'all tell me, who could it be but Steve Harvey?
Oh, yeah.
Listening to me. Mm-hmm. Put your hands together for Steve Harvey.
Put your hands together.
I sure will. Good morning, everybody. You all listening to The Voice. Come on, dig me now. One and only Steve Harvey, man, got a radio show. How good is God, huh? Think about it. Just take a slight inventory of your own life and say it to yourself when you get through. How good is God, huh? Think of all the small things. All this, because that's him. You breathing, that's him. You still here, that's him. You got another chance, that's him. You ain't out of here. That's him. You got any measure of health? That's him. You think it's more to it than it really is, than it already showed up to be? That's him. All of that. You got any dreams or aspirations? You dream of other things? That's him. All that. That's him. That's him. Them clothes you got? That's him. Every time you eat, that's why they had this thing called you say your grace. That's him. See, that's him, man. That's him. It's amazing when you take small inventory how you find out how big God really is in your life. Now, the more you turn yourself over to him, the bigger he can be for you. See, he'll only be as big as you let him. It's one thing about God. Now, he's a gentleman. He can make you do anything. You know, you get too big for him. You know, you lose your humbleness. He can humble you now. God created man with the power of choice. We're the only creature he created that he gave us the total power of choice. When we mate, who we mate with, you know, everything, all of it, man. It's a choice. What we want to be, how much we want to make, where we want to live, what climate we want to live in. We can live in cold climates, hot climates. You know, we speak different languages. You can go learn another language. A bear can't do nothing but be a bear. He can't go learn how to be a fox. He can't go learn how to be an otter. He just can't. An ostrich is an ostrich, man. He can't come out here and fight like a lion. A lion is a lion. A lion eat meat. He can't eat vegetables. I don't care how much meat ain't around. He'll lay down and pull up out of here and die because he can't eat grass. He's just a lion, man. You understand this? That God gave us. We are the one creature he created that has total power of choice. You can make every decision in your life. What kind of watch you like? That's the one you can buy. You want to live in Switzerland? Go ahead. You don't like Switzerland? You can move to Miami. You want to live your life of crime? Go ahead. That's you. He gave you the power of choice. You want to do right? Come on. So now, look at this thing. We are all the results of a series of decisions that we have made. If we could just identify that the problem is us, we could begin the solution. See, that's the problem, y'all. It's us. It's what we do. I threw my life down the hill. I can't tell you how many years based on some decisions that I was making. Now, I can justify my decision where I wasn't happy and I was doing this and I was in misery and y'all on there. Yeah, 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 Steve, when you get through, you made the decisions, though. Now, you can look at this any way you want to, y'all, but at the end of the day, I'm just talking to people that's really, really wanting to improve their position in life. And how do you do that? You got to have a solution. How do you come up with a solution? You got to identify the problem to even begin to solve it. But if the problem ain't ever you, how you gonna solve something that ain't you? See, okay, let me look at it this way. If somebody say, like, I got a child of mine, man. I just do right here, man. I don't even want to get into it this morning. Boy, I'm struggling with this boy. But man, you go to people, you ask them why they do something. I just wasn't taking care of business. Why? I just didn't take care of business. Boy, do you understand that your life is going to be filled with you got to take care of business? So when you going to start? You know, man, you can't go through life blaming everybody. It's got to be you. See, you can fix you. You can't fix nobody else. If you keep getting married and the marriages don't work, hello, could it be you? See, I finally had to sit down and just make that decision. Ain't no need of me coming on the radio talking about nobody else and what they did to me and y'all just don't know. No, man. What about the part you played in it? Because, see, if you got a good marriage, you got a part to play in that. If you got a bad one, you got a part to play in that. Even if it just get down to you the one picked them. How about that, Mister? I made a decision. The problem is usually within yourself. Do you know that's the quickest and easy way to fix your life? That way you ain't got to check with nobody. Here's the beauty of going on and admitting that it's you. You don't have to check or clear it with nobody to start the repair process. You don't need anybody's permission. You ain't got to put it before the review board to see if it'll pass. It ain't got to go through Congress. You ain't got to hope that your local politician get their hands on it and make a phone call for you. You ain't got to ask any counselors to come in and sit with you. You don't have to check into rehab. All you got to do is decide. The problem is me. I'm going to start changing me. Identify the problem and start with the part that you can own up to. Once you identify the problem, you can start planning on how to fix it or how to get to accomplishing something. But remember, this planning is important. If you fail to plan, then please plan to fail. If you don't know how to make a plan, let's just start with the basics. Just make a list of what you want. Make this list and then go to God in prayer with an open mind. And open your mind up to all the clean opportunities that are available. Here's why a lot of people won't succeed. Because certain opportunities come along, you don't want to do them. That kills me, man, when I hear people, I ain't doing that. I know young comedians that come to me all the time talking about, man, what you know? I said, man, just take every gig you can, no matter what it pay. Well, listen to me, son. You can go make that money that it pay, or you can make the decision to sit at home and make no money. It's a comedy hard business. They ain't paying but $100. You got to drive 50 miles. But if you drive 50 miles and you make the 100 and you stand on that stage for 30 minutes, you are now 30 minutes better than you was the last time you went on stage. Oh, man, they don't pay me. I ain't coming. You ain't finna be a comedian, man. Not like this here. A lot of people just don't want to do what's necessary to do. So when the opportunity presents itself and you open up your mind to it, man, then get ready to go on and do it, man. Identify your problem today. Start with the part that's you.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's get it started. Right now, it's morning time. Ain't no need to mess around. We got full complement. We only got one team member missing. This is Steve Harvey Morning Show. I chose to do it this way today because, well, I chose to do it this way today. That's all I need. Ain't no other reason. That's what it is this morning. Simply put, Shirley Strawberry.
I like that energy today, Steve. Happy Friday. Good morning.
Muscles.
Morning, Unc, to the family I wish I had.
Light skinned J. Anthony Brown.
Man, he talking. Jay on
the Zoom with so much light this morning. He looked like the light skinned dude in Kid and Play. That's how much light he got on him. Roy, you ain't been that light skinned since. I don't believe, as an embryo.
I was never this light at birth. You're right. Never.
Nephew Tommy.
In the building, 6 foot six. Yes, I am. What it do, baby? Looking down on y'all this morning. What's that?
6 foot six?
Yeah.
What's
6 foot six,
six,
boy?
What you standing on the counter?
What's six foot six?
Me.
I just want to know what is.
Boy,
6 foot six?
You ain't jump 6'6". Tommy, you ever tried to dunk?
Yeah.
That answers my question. That go to 6'6" for you.
What?
You don't know how far that is up there till you try to run up there.
It's 10 feet.
That's up there.
I know exactly how high it is.
It's 10
you
feet.
Don't know.
Yeah.
What are you, Steve? 6'2"?
6'2". I used to ram it. Wow. Now, that's used to. Mm-hmm. Them days gone, though.
I'm 6'4".
It's gone. Hey, man, let me explain something to you. I got a basketball hoop, right?
Uh-huh.
It got a cord net on it. So it rained outside. So, you know, when it rained, the net tightened up. I'm out there with Marjorie. We shooting balls. We ain't made one in about 6 shots. Mm-hmm. She messed around and threw one in, and it stuck in the net.
Mm-hmm. Oh, no.
You got to jump up there and knock it down.
You got to get it down.
And, you know, it was just stuck in the net.
Uh-huh.
And she said, baby, get that. And I stood there and looked. I said, damn. That
and
used to be
you
nothing.
You gotta get it.
You used to get it, huh?
Dog.
Back in the day.
So the first time I didn't realize how much hops I had lost, and I just missed the whole net and everything. Then my wife was looking at me, so I went back and took 2 steps and got up there and just barely got it out the net. But when I came down to the ground, the shock of hadn't jumped that far in years, shock. Shut my entire butt up and pushed it up in me a little bit. It just went up in me like I inhaled my butt inside of it. I didn't know what to do.
We get it.
Yeah.
Well, at least
so
you
we
got
quit
strong.
After that.
We get it.
Yeah.
You need to do like I do though, Steve.
All right. Thank you for that, Steve. Coming up at 32 minutes after the hour, ask the CLO, Chief Love Officer Steve Harvey, in the building right after this.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
All right, here we go. It is time to ask the CLO. This one's from Alana in Memphis. Alana writes, I'm a 54-year-old divorced female, and I'm dating a guy that my aunt hooked me up with. We were sitting in my yard relaxing, and he was playing on his phone when all of a sudden I heard sex sounds coming from his phone. Mm. I got up to see what he was watching, and it was a dark and dirty sex video. He said my aunt sent it to him. Why would my aunt send him a porn video? Do I need to see how close their relationship really is?
I don't know. The hell, what you asking me for? I don't even understand why you calling in. Mm-hmm. Everybody was right there. You was in the yard relaxing. Your aunt was over there. She sent him the video.
She missed her window, you saying?
Yeah, you could have cleared it with everybody right there. So I don't know.
I'd say you have to be pretty close friends to send a porno video.
Yeah. That would be my guess.
But if you think people who send porno movies out don't lie, you're dealing with wrong people.
a lot of us, I mean, a lot of people watch porn.
It's educational, actually.
It is. You learn things. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you do.
Okay, I think you guys are, you're missing the point a little bit. All right, we're moving on. Deanna. Deanna in Las Vegas says, I'm in my mid-30s and I like to think of myself as a freaky Christian. I met a man in church and I'm trying to figure out what's wrong with him. He's very well endowed and I am praying for the day he unleashes the beast. I don't think it will ever happen because he's so sensitive to my touch. If I touch him or it, it drives him crazy. How can I get started if I can't give him my extra special pre-show treatment? Please advise.
Wait a minute.
This is from Deanna, the freaky Christian.
What is you writing us for?
I know.
You know, you're the one that's the freaky Christian. How'd you get the reputation? What do you need help from us for? Nobody on this show is as labeled themselves as the freaky Christian.
No.
You're the freaky Christian, but now you got questions on how to be freaky.
You need to ask some more freaky people.
You know, maybe you need to give up the title.
Yeah.
Of freaky
Why don't you
Christian?
Just try Christian for a while?
She sounds pretty proud of that, though.
Yeah, but you ain't that freaky because you don't even know what to do. Now, you calling in to the people. Ain't no none of us said we a freaky Christian.
Ever.
Now, you want to call in to us and get some damn advice. If you freaky,
well,
get freaky.
What we have on the show is a freak and Christians. We don't have two titles.
Yeah, ain't no combination.
Yeah, and it's Ask the CLO, not Ask the Freaky Christian.
Yeah, so I ain't got nothing for you. I don't know what you need to do to in hell.
You're mad, Steve?
Yeah, maybe you ain't all. Hold on, hey, freaky Christian. Maybe you ain't freaky enough.
Hey, freaky you know? Christian.
Yeah, you ever thought of that? Maybe your title is a little overrated to him.
Yeah, that's something. All right, moving on. Paulette in Charlotte says, I'm dating a man that tried to be romantic, but it went left real quick. He ran my bath water and poured me some wine. The water wasn't warm enough, so I had to add hot water. I finally got the water right, and I was soaking. Then he brought his naked behind in there and slid into my bath water. I think that this is very unsanitary, and it darn sure isn't romantic to me. I got out of the tub and took a shower because I felt dirtier than I did before my bath. He told me I'm hard to please and I'm rude. Am I really?
Yeah, I think you are.
Yeah,
you know, the man run your bath water. He coming there to get in the bathtub. Now, he too nasty, but you finna lay up with him later on? I don't understand. You can't take a bath with him because you felt dirtier with who? Mm-hmm. What? Yeah. What?
Let's both come out of here clean. How about that?
Yeah, you know. It ain't like he took a bath like we used to do when we was little because we didn't have a big hot water tank.
Save that
like
water.
You had to use the same water. You had to get on in there.
Oh, you mean after a person got out?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
With a load of clothes in there. With a load of clothes.
What?
Yeah.
He takes it to a whole nother level.
So you agree with him that she's hard to please and she's rude?
Yes.
I mean, you know, lady, what you want, dog? Man, he tried to get his big self in there. What you think is supposed to what?
She thinks it's unsanitary.
Okay, well, you know, there's sex scenes all the time. People take baths together all the time.
Right.
You know, I don't know what you think y'all going to be doing later on, but, you know, it's going to be a little bit more in
than
each
a
bath. Other than bath water.
All right. Well, Jay, your turn. Do you have a question for the CLO?
Yes, I do have a question. You are with a woman. A partner of mine is with a woman who is way more freakier than he is ready to be. How does he get out of this relationship? I mean, she's really freaky.
Is she a
really
Christian?
Freaky. No Christian in this at all. Nothing Christian about this. How
Sometimes
does he get
you
out
just
of this?
Had to go on and just that one time, just go on and get your whole self toe out. You just had to go on and just get yourself
what
turned inside out. That when you got the one time, you just got to take it like a man. Like you're going to be in there making them like you're going to be hyperventilating. You're going to suck in a lot of wind because when they're doing real freaky stuff, you do this here a lot.
Are you allowed to cry if it's way painful? Then can you cry?
Wait, stop it, please.
Sounds like a tear is about to come out. Are you allowed to cry?
Jesus.
Don't bring him in.
I need you now. You see me down here?
That burns. Is it supposed to burn like that? What's going on?
Yes.
What is the hot stick for? What you doing?
Brandy.
I don't. What is that? Stop beating me. No, I don't like that on my mouth. What you doing?
All right, thank you, CLO.
No, I'm not rubbing this on you right there.
We got to get out of here. Coming up next, the nephew is back with Run That Prank Back right after this.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
Coming up at the top of the hour, Miss Anne will be here with our national news. And in entertainment news, a highly anticipated versus battle of the 90s girl groups is tomorrow. And we'll tell you how the pandemic led to a lot of big old butts, okay?
Yes.
You guys will be interested in that. But, right now, it is time to run that prank back. See what I did right there? What you got for us, Neff?
I got it for you.
I know you do,
I spent your credit card. Let's go, cat dog.
Hello?
I'm trying to reach Anthony.
Anthony, this is
Jay Will. I'm the bartender here at the club.
Yeah, man, I've been calling y'all all week, man, about my card.
Yes, I got your card. You actually, you must have left it here Saturday night, is that right?
Yeah, I left it up there Saturday, man, but I've been calling y'all all week, man, trying to get my card.
We don't normally come back in until Thursday or Thursday morning. We get the liquor ready for Thursday night, so nobody's actually here. I just happen to be coming.
I understand that, man, but y'all run your business, man. Y'all got to get somebody to start answering the phones, man. I need my card all week.
Right.
Where y'all at right now so I can come pick up my card? Y'all at the club?
No, I'm not. I just left the club, actually. I'm actually almost home, but I do have your card with me.
Oh, wait. You got my card with you?
Yes, I have your credit card.
Why you took my car to the house?
Well, I saw all the messages that you left on the machine, so I'm assuming that if I reached out to you, maybe we could meet up and I could actually help you out and get it to you before Thursday.
Yeah, but that's cool, man, but I could have just met you at the club. If you saw my call, you should have just called me back. I could have came right over to the club, man.
Okay, well, I apologize. I got a lot of running around to do, but if you don't mind coming out and picking it up from me here at the house, you know, I'd make sure I get it to you.
Okay, cool. Well, look, check this out. What's your address, man, so I can just come over there to you right now? I'm going to put it in GPS and run over there.
Okay, it's...
Hold on.
Right, street.
All right. All right, cool. Well, look, man, you there now? Because I can just shoot over there right quick. And I applaud you a little something, man, for taking care of that, man. Because I really need my car, man. I got some urgent business I need to take care of. So I just shoot you a little something when I get over there. And I appreciate it again, man.
Okay. Well, you know, I appreciate you, you know, wanting to slide me something. And since you said that, you know, maybe you don't have to, because I ran into a little jam, man. And hopefully you'll be understandable about it. But I ran into a little jam, and I actually had to... I actually had to use your card.
Hold on. Wait. You said what?
Well, I got into a little situation and I actually had to use your card.
Use my card.
Right. Well, yeah. I mean, I'll be able to give it back, pay it back to you.
Man,
you
know what I'm saying? Use my card. What the hell y'all got kind of operation y'all got going on over there, man? Use my car for what? I closed my tab out on Saturday night, man.
Yeah, you closed your tab out, you know, and like I said, I was going through a little bit of a situation. I needed some gas, so I used it for that, and my little girl needed some uniforms for her school, and my check hadn't come from the club yet, but
slow down, bro. You put gas and you buying somebody children some clothes. On my car?
Right, and I had to get my car out of the shop. So, I mean, once I...
Come on, your car out the shop. Man, let me tell you something, man. You with my family, man. You with my family money, man. I'll you up for that, bro. I don't play for that, man. I'm going to tell you what, man. I'm going to file a police report, man. I'm
gonna
f you up, man. You need to have my car.
I can, Mr. Anthony, just calm down, man. I know it's a little.
No, ain't no calm down, nothing.
But But at least
I got a family, man. I got my own kids to take care of.
But at least I'm telling you what happened, and you're not.
I don't give a damn about you telling me. You should have used my car. My car should have been at the club where I left it at.
I can pay you back in payments, man. Every week.
I want my money. And I want my car back. I'm gonna bust your. That's what it's gonna be.
Sir,
that's what it's gonna be.
If your car was that important, you wouldn't have left it at the club.
Man, I don't give a damn. People leave their car out. Time.
Well, if you wouldn't have been so,
you
if you wouldn't,
wanted, the girl had my car the whole time. Said she was gonna save it for me and give it to me. And I signed my thing, and she didn't give it to me.
If you wouldn't have been so drunk, you wouldn't have left your car at the club.
Hold on. Nobody up, man. I had two drinks, man. But that don't excuse the fact I had some friends and business I need to leave. But that don't excuse you to use my car, man.
I understand that,
man,
but I'm telling you,
where you at right now, man? Where you at? You at this address? You at this address?
Yes, I am.
I'm on the way over there, man, and I'm telling you what, man. If you don't have my card and my money when I get there, I'm going to bust your wide open.
I understand. It took me $400 to get my car out the shop.
$400? Out of my car?
Well, no. It was actually $600 on your car because I had to get the other stuff that I told you about. But
You crazy. You done up. That's what you done. You done really messed up, man. Hey, say, man. Hey, look, man. That's my wife. That's me and my wife joint savings account, man. That's for my kids. I got two kids to take care of, man. I don't know what type of game you trying to run, man. But I promise you this. I got something for you. I want all my money on my account. And if any money, I'm telling you right now, I swear to God.
I've already told you that I've used this money. What do you mean if it's not there? It's not there.
Okay.
I've used
That's
it,
cool.
Anthony.
Hey,
but
man,
I'm asking you to let me put a paper.
Let me tell you something. I swear to God right now, I promise. Woo, I swear, if you don't have my together when I get over there, I'm going to put my hands on you, man. And I don't know who you think you're playing with, man. I don't play these boy games. I hope... I don't think this is gonna go. I'ma sue the pants off that. I'm gonna sue the black off that. I want my car and I want my money. Real go. If my money ain't back on my car, by the time I get over there, got the cash in my hand, by the time I get over there, we're gonna have a real serious problem. And I'm done talking.
Hello?
Hey, you ain't got to call me. I'm already on the way. I swear to God, let my money be off my car. Let my not be there. I hope it's not right. I'm gonna you up, man. I'm telling you right now. I put my right hand to God on my daughter right now. If my money ain't on my car, if the card ain't in my hand, with my money in my hand when I get over there, don't even worry about it. I'm on the way over there. I'll be there in less than 10 minutes.
I want to be honest about this. Somebody actually gave me your card.
What?
Somebody actually gave me your card.
Somebody gave you my card. I don't give a damn who gave you the card. It's your that I'm seeing when I get over there. So that's fine. I hope y'all had fun with the little game y'all play. That's fine. That's cool. Man, I ain't got time to play these Mickey Mouse games with you.
The other person has the card.
Who the got my card, man? I ain't got time to be running around with y'all.
Okay, do you have something you can take his name down so I can...
Take his name down, man. I want to know who's got my card, man.
Okay, the guy from the Steve Harvey Morning Show, he has your card. Nephew Tommy from the Steve Harvey Morning Show, you just gotta pray.
Oh, man. Come on, man. Man, I got my real money on that car, man.
Come on,
man. I got my real money on there, man.
Hey, man. Your boy.
I wasn't asking about this car all weekend, man.
He said, you've been calling the club every single 10 minutes.
Man, my wife ain't let me leave this down, man. She hot. He can't even pull that money off of this morning. I don't know, man. It's serious out here, man.
Hey, let me ask you something. What's the baddest radio show in the land, baby?
Steve Harvey Morning Show.
Did I do y'all justice? That's all I want.
You did.
All right. Thank you, Neff. Coming up at the top of the hour, we'll have entertainment and national news with Miss Ann Tripp right after this.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
Coming up in about 20 minutes, guys, our special guest will be family member Anthony Hamilton. He is back with a world premiere of his new single, and we can't wait for that.
Not wait.
yeah, we've missed Anthony
right
for
there.
Sure.
He is a singing man.
Yeah,
he really is.
Well, it's on, guys. The upcoming Verzuz battle between two of our most beloved '90s R&B girl groups. It is tomorrow night at 8 p.m. Eastern. The last time we talked about Verzuz, of course, it was the Isley Brothers and Earth, Wind & Fire, hosted by our very own Steve Harvey. Well, this one's going to be good too. It's a showdown between SWV and Xscape. Yeah. SWV and Xscape. Two singing groups right there. Singing, okay?
Banging.
Yes. Tomorrow also marks the one-year anniversary of the Verzuz battle. So we're going to break it down. So who do you think has the best vocals or the best catalog of music, Steve? Jay, Tommy, Junior, anybody for this cool. one. Of SWV and Xscape.
Oh, I don't know.
Yeah.
I'd have to go with
both of them. Both of them girls hit the blow.
Both got hit.
They like Coco.
I get so weak in the knees. I can lose all control. It's a taste over me. I'll be doing all that.
Yes, yes, yes. All right.
I'm with Junior. I'm on SWV.
So be sure to tune in tomorrow at 8 p.m. Eastern at Verzuz TV on Instagram.
Which
or
one
on
of them got candy in it?
That's Xscape.
Xscape.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Those
she wrote most of the songs.
And
she
wrote hits, though.
For not just Xscape, for everybody.
She wrote a lot of songs, yeah.
Yeah. So that'll be a fun one. That'll be a fun one, too. And in other great news, it turns out that the pandemic was good for something. Check this out, guys. The American Society of Plastic Surgeons reports that procedures like Botox and fillers were very, very popular during the COVID pandemic. But the biggest increase in cosmetic surgery in the last year was for
butts.
What, guys?
Butt
implants. Yes, butt implants. Apparently, being
should've
home
should have been for
and
butt reductions with all that damn weight I saw.
I'm with you, Steve. I'm seeing some asses that I have never seen asses as big as I'm seeing now.
That's because they bought them, Jay.
Huge.
No.
Now, I like a big ass. Don't get me wrong. I like a big ass, but some of these asses.
You're talking about the COVID-15, Steve.
I'm talking about asses.
But you're talking about the weight that people gain.
I'm talking about COVID when you look back there and discover it.
COVID-19.
Because, you know, in COVID, you know, you wore a lot of gym stuff because you wasn't going nowhere.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Then as you started going back out and you was trying to put your clothes on.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yep. So, oh, you know what I wanted to ask you? So, does it matter to you?
How much do an ass cost, Shirley?
I don't know.
Go ahead, Shirley.
What are you asking me? I was going to ask you. Can you tell that if it's fake or not, or do you care?
Yeah.
I mean, sometimes you can.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. If it's in my hand,
sometimes you
I
don't
can.
Care.
Yeah, but I don't care, though.
Oh, you don't care.
If you got money involved, you don't care. That's just
if your waistline is real, real tiny.
Yeah.
No, that ain't happening.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, if you hit it and it hurts your hand, then you care. Then you know.
That's new.
That's the only time you care.
And if it feel like concrete, Jay.
If it feel like concrete.
If it don't ripple when you hit it.
All right. We're moving on. Time to check in with Miss Ann Tripp, Steve.
Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Ann Tripp.
Thank you. Thank you, everybody. Good morning, folks. This is Antrip with the news on this Friday. President Biden took his campaign for his massive infrastructure plans to the people of the Deep South yesterday. Mr. Biden met first with Louisiana Governor John Bel Edwards to talk about disaster preparedness. And then he went to New Orleans to convince people that his billion-dollar ideas will make America more competitive and attractive for business investment and therefore bring more jobs. But while the president says he's willing to entertain ideas from congressional Republicans and all this, he says he's not going to be stalled by any legislative games.
I'm not ready to do nothing. I'm not ready to have another period where America has another infrastructure month and doesn't change a damn thing.
Meanwhile, the Republican mayor of Lake Charles and the Democratic mayor of Shreveport, they recently got together and co-wrote an op-ed piece on the need to pass Mr. Biden's American Jobs Plan. Scary times in South Carolina yesterday. A school bus filled with children was hijacked by an Army trainee with a rifle. Authorities say the youngsters and the driver, okay, thank goodness. The suspect is under arrest, thank goodness, and faces a number of kidnapping charges. Richland County Sheriff Leon Lott says they found out about it from a parent of one of the kids who was on the bus.
Probably one of the scariest calls that we could get in law enforcement as a school district is that a school bus has been hijacked with kids on it. With someone with a gun.
Again, it turned out that the suspect's under arrest and nobody was hurt. The unidentified trainee was only a few weeks into basic training at Fort Jackson. A South Carolina appeals court has ruled that a mentally disabled black man held as a slave for 5 years by a white restaurant owner is due $500,000 in back wage and benefits. Authorities say that John Christopher Smith worked at the restaurant since he was 12 years old. He was paid by the family who owned the restaurant, but when they decided to give it to another family member to run, this particular person, 56-year-old Bobby Paul Edwards, stopped paying him and put him in a roach-infested apartment and barely gave him anything to eat. Prosecutors say other workers noticed what was going on, but they were afraid to say anything because they were afraid of getting fired. By the way, that guy, 56-year-old Bobby Paul Edwards, who kept him as a slave, he's in jail. Meghan Markle has written a new book, a children's book entitled The Bench. It's about the relationship between a father and a son, you know, her husband and Archie. But already those racist haters are out there.
They're here.
Yeah, they're here again. Another children's book called The Boy and the Bench. Those Meghan-hating creeps have insisted that the Duchess of Sussex book is identical to the other one. So they asked the author. She says, wrong. She says her book is not the same at all, and the theme of the book is completely different than Meghan's. Now they want the Queen to remove Meghan's title as Duchess of Sussex from the book. Those ugly people never, ever stop. Now back to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
All right, y'all, here we go, everybody. As promised, we got our special guest this morning. Man, this is a family member, y'all. Grammy Award winner, singer, songwriter, producer, author. He done sold over 50 million albums globally.
Woo.
Y'all heard me. And he ain't numbered family to us. It's only right that he stopped by here this morning to do the world premiere of his new single, You Made a Fool of Me. Mm. Ladies and gentlemen, none other than that damn Mr. Anthony Hamilton.
Glad to be back with the old team again.
Man, it's real. Hey, man, how you been holding up during the pandemic? You been vaccinated? How you been holding up?
I've been holding up pretty good at the end of COVID, actually, in December. I was in the hospital 2 weeks. You know, kept it really quiet. My younger three boys, they end up having it. But, you know, man, God had plans for me, and here I am. I came out of there singing my tail off.
Amen.
You know, I can't. Look, I was singing in there on that bed. I was like, if I could just sing Charlene, I'd be all right. I can make a few dollars if I could just sing Charlene.
Hey, man, but you were in the hospital for 2 weeks, Anthony.
Yeah.
Bro, that's serious.
Yeah, it was serious. You know, they had me on oxygen. I didn't have to go on the ventilator, but I was on oxygen. I hadn't been sick in over 10, 15 years, man. Mm. If I had a cold, it'd be 2 days, top. Maybe it was just for me to have a testimony to tell people that it was real. But I'm glad I was spared. And
thank God.
Yeah. Hey, man, you're back. That's for real. Stronger than ever. Thank God.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's good, man. So the family good and everything? How your sons doing?
Yeah, everybody's good. The kids, everybody's good. They're eating snacks after every meal. And, you know, it's regular.
Well, hey, man, look. We on here because we're going to do the world premiere of your new single, You Made a Fool of Me. Man, so just before we go to break, man, how did the song come about?
You know what? I was in the studio, man. Me, Jermaine Dupri, we're in the studio, and we were just talking about, like, life and relationships, and we started talking about Charlene was created and just all the things we feel, and, you know, talking about how you've been made a fool of and things you go through, and me, Eddie Kane, and Jermaine Dupri, he started making this music. Emmanuel Steele. I was like, man, that sounds so old. I said, you don't want to try nothing a little new? He's like, he said, you ain't never got to do nothing new.
No.
You know what I mean? Because, hey, you know, sometimes as an artist, you want to, you know, everything is popping and it's new and it's fresh and it's a different sound. And, you know, I like a little bit of that. He's like, you don't ever have to do that for your core audience. He's like, they want to hear you. He said, they want to hear you sing. Ain't nobody that's singing it like you like that right now.
No, that's exactly right.
Yeah. You know, and I respect him for that. Jermaine has always been that, like, you don't have to be none of that.
No.
You do this extremely well. And he was like, I ain't never made no music like this, ever.
You ain't got to fix nothing that ain't broke. And when we come back, we gonna do the world premiere, everybody. So don't go nowhere. You Made a Fool of Me is next. It's brand new from Anthony Hamilton, world premiere right after this.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
All right, everybody, we're back. And as promised, we're sitting here with our family member, legendary Grammy Award-winning singer, songwriter, producer, author.
This is Anthony Hamilton, and this is my brand new single, You Made a Fool of Me, right here on the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
You made a fool of me. I gave you all I had.
You could never do no wrong. And you know I adored you. But you chose to break my heart. You were sleeping with another man. And you had him all around our friends. You never said you were sorry for what you did. And I can never do you like that.
You made a fool of me.
You made a fool of me.
I gave you all I had.
I gave you all I had.
You made a fool of me.
You made a fool of me.
I'll never take you back.
Oh, no, 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 no. And girl, you know you had me wrapped around your heart. Oh, I was it worth losing all we had? I was there from the start. Ooh, yeah.
No one, nobody
could ever love you like I
ever,
did.
Ever, ever.
No, 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 no,
never,
no.
He can sing ABC and go Grammy.
Man, right there in your heart. Your heart.
For what?
Yeah.
Jermaine Dupri said it best. Change for what?
Yes.
Dog, you got that voice. You got that voice that's not out there today. And it's the voice that's been missing. Dog, I like that little Lenny Williams. That little Lenny Williams.
It just felt like I needed to go... Oh,
wow, oh, wow, oh, wow.
You got
it.
Oh, Lord.
See right there?
Man. Ooh, I wish I
right
could
there.
Do that, man.
Oh, dog, let me tell you something. If I could do that right there, well.
What?
Well, if I could do that, though, I'd be broke.
Why?
Yeah, because you're going to need to be able to do more than that to make it. That ain't good enough. Hey, man, you working on a new album?
New album will be done and out in August.
Beautiful.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
I mean, I'm coming with it. I'm coming like this is my first album. Like, I've never, ever put an album out. I'm coming like Charlene, that whole Coming From Where I'm From album.
Come on.
Yeah.
Come on, boy.
This is going to be the grown-up, it's going to be the steroid version of that, man. I'm excited.
Hey, congratulations, man. We love you, boy. Ladies and gentlemen, the one and only Anthony Hamilton. We love you, boy.
Yeah, my man.
Thank y'all. Love y'all too, man. Thank you to my
Always.
Fans.
All right. We'll have more of the Steve Harvey Morning Show right after this.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
Coming up at the top of the hour, right about 4 minutes after, it's my strawberry letter for today. The subject, I fell in love with the Cookie Monster. We'll get into that. A little later, but right now it is time for the prank call. All right, nephew, what you got?
Well, you know, some people are sensitive about their kids, Shirley. You know, I don't know where that comes
from. Most people are.
A lot of people are sensitive about their kids. So today's prank
is. You know where
it comes from? I don't. Okay. I don't. But today's title is Your Son is Too Fat.
Oh, wow.
Your Son is Too Fat. Let's go, Kat.
Hello?
Hello, I'm trying to reach Kathy, please.
This is her.
Hi, Kathy. This is Kirby. I'm actually the owner at the daycare, Mines Daycare, where your son comes.
Okay.
All right. I'm sure you're familiar with my wife, Benita.
Yes, sir.
All right. How you doing today?
I'm good.
Oh, how's our little Devon? How's he doing?
He's good. He's laying down taking a nap.
Okay. You guys been coming here, I guess, about a year now, right?
Yeah, since he was one.
Okay. Listen, I wanted to give you a call. I'm looking at some information. How is Devon doing at home? Is he eating properly at home?
When you say eating, what do you mean?
I mean, is he getting meals every time he's supposed to get them while he's at home?
Yeah. He's doing pretty good.
Okay, now there's no situation where you guys may be a shortage of food or anything like that, are you?
Wait a minute, shortage of food? No, sir, my husband works real good. We don't have a problem with a shortage of food. Is there a problem with him?
Well, you know, we're looking at the records, and Lil Devon is two.
Yes, sir.
Have you looked at the comparison of two-year-olds? The majority of two-year-olds in comparison to, I guess I should say size, in comparison to Devon's size?
You mean like in body weight, body size? Yeah, I mean, he's a little tall, you know. He wasn't a small child when he was born. He was 10 pounds, but no, he's on the scale of right where he should be. He's just a little, you know, taller because his daddy is tall, but he's doing
okay. So you don't think he's anywhere in the ballpark of obesity?
At two, you mean fat?
I mean, I didn't want to be blunt, but Miss Kathy, you're. I mean, your son's.
Let me just say, on a Sunday, I'm relaxing, and we talking about. You think my son is a little overweight or what? He's what's the problem?
I think he's fat. You know, and the problem I'm having here is
fat.
That I'm noticing the records of everything as
well. Wait. We need to back up to you think he's fat. I've never spoken to you. Mr. Kirby, is that what you said?
My name is Kirby.
Okay, so every morning that I drop him off for a year and I give my daycare money, Miss Benita has never said anything about his eating habits. So you're telling me that you think my son is fat? Do you deal with him on a daily basis?
I don't deal with him on a daily basis. What I'm looking at is records that are showing me that he's eating way more than the rest of anybody at the daycare. And not only that, he's drinking probably a gallon of milk a day.
Gallon of milk. Y'all only get snacks two times a day, and he's there only for breakfast and lunch. And how in the hell is he drinking a gallon of milk? And if he is drinking a gallon of milk, do you need me to drink a gallon?
I'm blown away by this, ma'am, but all I know is this.
No, I'm blown away by this because you calling me on a Sunday calling my damn child fat. That's the problem. And your wife has never said a damn thing. Never has she said one thing to me in a year when she collected my damn daycare money. She ain't said my son is eating y'all at a house and home.
Okay, well, you know, my wife's a different person, and she tries to be cordial with everyone.
Well, she's the one who deals with me, Mr. Kirby. I've never met you. Never met you. Especially on a Sunday.
Well, the reason why I'm calling you on a Sunday, ma'am, is that I know tomorrow you're going to be trying to drop your son off.
I am going to drop him off.
No, that's kind of the reason why I'm calling you. Now, here's
what we can do.
There's two alternatives here. Either you can keep him at home.
No, I'm not keeping him at home. My husband works, and I work. I'm dropping my damn son off at 6:30 like I do every morning.
Okay, ma'am, listen. If we can't get him at the regular
weight
that he needs to be at.
You might want to get Miss Benita on this phone, because obviously you ain't the one that need to be talking to me. Because if you're not there every day, and I deal with your wife.
Ma'am, I'm telling you that your son is too big to be.
His fat is coming every morning, if that's the case. And if he's eating at a house and home, I'll send him some extra. But what I pay my money for is what you're going to feed him for. Two full meals and two snacks. And if he need extra, I'll put some in his bag.
But he's drinking a gallon of milk a day.
I don't care. There's no way possible that he can drink a gallon of milk a day.
Okay. Here's the deal. I don't want you to have to stop bringing your son there.
And I'm not.
Here's my second alternative. I will put him on a diet, okay? I'll give him an apple in a day.
You ain't no damn doctor. Are you from the health food program?
Ma'am, I will give him an apple and a glass of water in the morning, and I'll give him an apple and a glass of water in the evening, and then you guys can feed him when he gets home.
You must be certified in the food program, especially if you sitting up here telling me my damn son is going on a diet, and he's not drinking no water and no apple, he needs a full snack. If the other kids is having an apple and water, then that's what you better be serving him. But if that ain't the case, then hell no, he better get the full snack. So if that's graham crackers and apple juice, well, damn it, that's what my son better be getting. And if he want extra, he better get it.
Ma'am, listen, all I'm trying to tell you is your son drank too much. He drinks too much milk on a daily basis.
Whoa. You need to back the up. I know you did not cuss at me. I did not cuss at you.
No. I caught myself.
You got ready to cuss at me. Let me tell you one thing. You ain't got to worry about it. We don't have nothing else to talk about. My husband, me, your wife, and everybody that works at that damn daycare better be there in the morning because at 6:30, we going to be there. And my son, he's coming all week, and he going to eat all week. If he want 2 gallons of milk, he gonna drink it. If he want 2 plates of food, he gonna get it. Cause I tell you what, we pay damn good money to come to that daycare. So
ma'am, let me explain something. You gonna bring your child up there, then I'm gonna have to put him on some slim fast. Now I will put your child on slim fast. I was trying not to
give
go to this perspective, but I will.
Fast. Give him some slim fast, and you gonna get a slim fast whooping. I'm gonna whoop your and whoever gave it to him. Whoever gave it to him, they gonna get a slim fast whooping. All them little kids better have some slim fast. If he getting some, he better eat whatever they eating. If they eating steak, well, damn it, he better have some, too.
If we had steak, he'd probably eat the whole damn cow.
Well,
he
I
eating
don't
too.
Care. I pay for it, but he better not get no slim fast. I will shut it the down about my child.
Okay, I got something else you need to know about your son.
What the else do I need to know besides you think my son is overweight? What the else can you tell me today?
I need to tell you this. I need to tell you that this is Nephew Tommy from the Steve Harvey Morning Show. Your girlfriend Lucretia got me to prank phone call you.
What the did you just say? What the did you just say?
This is Nephew Tommy from the Steve Harvey Morning Show. Your girlfriend Lucretia got me to prank phone call you.
I'm going to beat that to death. She know I don't play about my damn son. At all. That's my only son. I don't play about him. I'm going to be there. Is she there?
Can she hear me? Baby.
It's on after this. It's on.
It's on?
It is on.
Hey, I got one more thing I got to ask you, baby. What is? What is the baddest, and I mean the baddest, radio show in the land?
The Steve Harvey Morning Show. It's on. I'm whooping. It's on. I hope you can hear me. Wherever you at laughing, it's on.
Wherever you are laughing.
The question is, Tommy, was he fat? Is he really fat?
He's a little chubby. He's a little chubby.
He's
a little chubby.
But he's tall, though. Because his daddy tall.
Because his daddy
tall. For two.
I don't give a damn. There ain't no high. A gallon of milk a day. Boy, you know how much milk that is. How the hell is he drinking? I'm giving your son some water and an apple. Boy.
She was not having
not
it.
At all.
No. I'm going to put him on that slim fast. That's what I'm going to put him on.
I love her. She's my, okay, his fat ass is coming in there.
If you want to drink two gallons of milk, you better drink it. If you want to eat 2 meals, you better eat it.
I'm going to call A.D. Dolphin and get some baby D herb. That's what I'm going to get him for.
All right, thank you, nephew. Great one. All right, coming up next, Strawberry Letter, subject, I fell in love with the Cookie Monster. We'll get into it right after this.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
It is time now for today's Strawberry Letter, and if you need advice on relationships, dating, work, sex, parenting, and more, please submit your Strawberry Letter to steveharveyfm.com. And who knows, we could be reading your Strawberry Letter, just like we're going to read this one right here, right now. It could be yours. You never know.
Yeah. Buckle up and hold on tight. We got it for you. Here it is, the Strawberry Letter.
Subject, I fell in love with the Cookie Monster. Dear Stephen Shirley, in 2017, I met a handsome man at a nail salon. He stared at me the entire time, so I gave him my card as I left. He called and invited me to his apartment for dinner, and we've been together since that night. He's a big flirt and a bit too outgoing, and it's always bothered me. 2 years ago, I started checking his phone, and he was always talking to different women. Whenever I called him a flirt, he would say he's a people person. He works long hours, and I don't get to see him every day, so that bothers me too. We're friends on Facebook, but he's always said he didn't like Instagram. Well, I guess he changed his mind about it because I found out he created a private Instagram account and he had blocked me. I was so upset that I created a fake Instagram account and I sent him a friend request. He let me follow him and I started flirting with him in the DMs. I asked if he was married or dating anyone. He said he has someone special in his life, but it's an open relationship. I couldn't believe him. I started stalking his comments and I sent messages to women that left hearts emojis on his pictures. I told them I was his wife. Four women responded and said they'd had sex with him within the past 2 years. I printed the messages and confronted him. He said it was all true. And he said that I may have assumed we were monogamous, but he has never told me that. He jokingly referred to himself as the cookie monster, and he was trying to get all the cookies he could before he settled down. He said he's in love with me despite how crazy I acted, and he wants to marry me one day. Do you think the cookie monster is gone for good? Can I trust this man as my husband? Is the cookie monster gone for good, and can I trust this man as my husband, you ask? Well, can you trust him as a boyfriend now? That's what you have to ask yourself. I think the answer is no, because right now he is who he is, a man who refers to himself as the cookie monster, trying to get all the cookies he can right now. I think the best thing about him that I can see is that he did come clean with you after you busted him, you know, about the women and everything. In this letter, though, you left out a lot, like how much time passed from when he called you and when you went to his apartment for dinner. You also didn't say if you guys had sex that night. I'm assuming you did. You say, you know, he told you one of his entanglements that, you know, one of them that you were special. He did have someone special in his life, but it was an open relationship. You didn't know anything about this being an open relationship. And how's that for feeling special? You didn't even know anything. He didn't say this to you. I think you started with him too fast. I don't think you set any boundaries with him. So he just put you in the open category while you looked at him as your man. But he's everybody's man, it seems. You know, he's trying to get all the cookies he can. That's what he said. So, you know, tell him how you feel and what you want. And if you don't get that, maybe you need to leave the cookie monster. I certainly think you deserve better, but you got to let him know it. Steve?
Well, ma'am that wrote this letter, if you had read your letter as you wrote it, you'd answer these questions yourself. The number one question is, can I trust this man as my husband? What are you talking about husband for? How did you get there? So let me show you something. Man was staring at you while you was getting your nails. So afterwards, you gave him your card. As I left, he called me and invited me to his apartment for dinner. Okay, you left. He called you the next day. This is all this is, Shirley. This ain't no time went by.
I know.
He called me, invited you to his apartment for dinner. You go over a man's house you don't know. And we have been together since that night. Well, something had to go down that night to seal the deal. They had sex. Because they've been together since that night.
Right.
Well, he's a big flirt and a bit too outgoing. And it's always bothered me. Why are we talking about this man being your husband? 2 years ago, I started checking his phone, and he's always talking to different women. Why are we talking about this man being your husband? And then your question is, can I trust this man as my husband? He's always talking to different women. Whenever I call him a flirt, he would say he's a people person. Can you trust him? You know he's a flirt. He tells you he's a people person. Why are you talking about making this man your husband? He works long hours. I don't get to see him every day, so that bothers me too. we friends on Facebook, but he always said he didn't like Instagram. Well, I guess he changed his mind because I found out he created a private Instagram account, and he has blocked me. Let's go back to the bottom of the letter. Can I trust this man as my husband? He done created a private page and done blocked you. Can I trust this man as my husband? Why are you asking this question? We come back, I'm going to tell you the rest of it. I promise you.
All right. Thank you, Steve.
It's just
we'll
more
have part
of the
two
same.
Of your response coming up at 23 minutes after the hour.
Oh, it's going to be more of the same.
I know. Subject, I fell in love with the Cookie Monster. We'll get into it right after this.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
All right, Steve, come on. Let's recap today's strawberry letter. Subject, I fell in love with the Cookie Monster.
This woman wants to know if we think that the Cookie Monster's gone for good. Then the next question is, can I trust this man? Then her statement was, as my husband. And I've showed you all through the letter why you can't trust or why you want to make him your husband. You gave this man your card after he was staring at you in the nail salon. He invited you to his apartment for dinner, and y'all been together ever since that night, which means you had sex and you've been with him ever since. He's a big flirt and a bit too outgoing, and it's always bothered me. So why are you talking about making him your husband? 2 years ago, I started checking his phone, and he's always talking to different women. Okay, your question is, how can I trust this man as my husband? Right now, you can't trust him or don't look like you're going to make him your husband. Whenever I called him a flirt, he would say he's a people person. Well, that's good. He changed the title of that right quick. But why are you talking about making him your husband? He works long hours. I don't get to see him every day, so that bothers me too. We friends on Facebook, but he's always said he didn't like Instagram. I guess he changed his mind about it because I found out he created a private page and he has blocked me. Why do you think you can trust him with the private page and then blocked you? Why? Why are you even talking about this man being your husband? So I was upset. You created a fake Instagram account, sent him a friend request. He let me follow him, and I started flirting with him in the DMs. Right there. I asked if he was married or dating anyone. He said he has someone special in his life. This line should have gave you plenty of hope. But it's an open relationship. Well, he snatched that rug right back out from under your feet. Thought you had something. No, you don't. I couldn't believe him. I started stalking his comments. And then you sent messages to women. You had to stalk his comments. And this is a man you want to know if you could trust or make your husband. I sent messages to several women that left hearts and emojis on his pictures. I told him I was his wife. 4 women responded and said they'd had sex with him within the past 2 years. These are the same 2 years you was dating him after you slept with him the first night, right? So now the whole time he didn't have 4 other women. That's 4 that you know about. I printed the message, confronted him. He said it was all true. And he said that I may have assumed we were monogamous, but he has never told me that. So why are you asking me and Shirley, can I trust this man as my husband when you can't trust him as your boyfriend? If you can't trust him as your boyfriend, why are you talking about going this any further? He jokingly referred to himself as a cookie monster, and he was trying to get all the cookies he could before he settled down. Okay, I guess he'll notify you when that's going to happen too. Because he didn't tell you nothing about the other women and all this here, right? Now watch this here. He said he's in love with me despite how crazy I am acting, and he wants to marry me one day. Hmm. Well, that's a hold'em. That's a pretty good hold'em line. I want to marry you one day. So that'll give you enough to hang on, right? Mm-hmm. Do you think the Cookie Monster is gone for good? Well, let me ask you something. Did he tell you that the Cookie Monster was gone? Because I didn't hear that in the letter. Did he say that? Everything else he said he didn't like Instagram. He had a fake page. And now he's telling you that he wants all the cookies he can get, and you still want to know if you can trust him and make him your husband. No, the Cookie Man ain't gone. And, of course, he said he wanted to marry you. That's to hold you. Lady, pull yourself together. I got you got 2 years invested. But I tell women all this time, you might have 2 years invested. You got two more years to waste. Quit trying to measure everything with how much time you got invested and ask yourself, how much more time do I have in this type of mess that you obviously don't agree with? No, the Cookie Monster ain't gone. He didn't tell you he was, just like he didn't tell you. See, you thought you was in a monogamous relationship, but he said, I never told you that. He didn't tell you he had a fake account either. He didn't tell you he had screwed four women in 2 years that you found out about. He ain't told you nothing. Mm-mm. What he did tell you that he's a people person. You call him a flirt. He quickly changed that because he don't like that. I'm a people person.
I like people, especially women.
Yeah, I like. I'm trying to get all the cookie I can before I settle down. Well, he ain't told you when he was going to settle down either, did he? You're in a crazy-ass relationship for 2 years. You don't have something you think you have, man. Mm-hmm. You don't have a monogamous relationship. You don't have a man you could trust, and you want a man that told you he wants to marry you, but he ain't told you when that would be. Lady, okay. That's all I got for you. Anybody want to ask something?
It takes all that to find out if he's trustworthy and something wrong with you. You kept finding out stuff, and you stayed. Yeah.
And he's steady.
Yeah,
how many cookies you think he got in the cookie jar? How many?
Oh, he got his hand up, his hand all down at the bottom of the cookie jar.
All kinds of cookies.
He got cookie crumbs all under his fingernails. Mm-hmm.
Chocolate chip, peanut butter,
pecan sandwich, vanilla cream,
Oreo cookies. Yeah.
Oh yeah, he like all that.
Like all
right. Thanks, Steve.
The little windmill cookie.
Vanilla wafers, yeah, you got that.
Chocolate.
Coming up, guys, coming up.
Ice cream.
Let the excitement begin. It's Mother's Day this Sunday. So our poet laureate is here, Junior, with a Mother's Day poem right after this.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, it is time. I know you've been waiting. Mother's Day is this Sunday. Junior, step up to the mic and let us have it.
Yes, ladies and gentlemen, let me introduce to you, I finally come up with the perfect name that fits him on Poetry Day. Ladies and gentlemen, J-Rap.
Thank you. Thank you. J-Rap is in the building. Thank y'all so much.
Somebody please ask me what J-Rap stands for.
What does that mean?
What does it stand for, Steve?
Junior's Raggedy Ass Poems.
All right, J-Rap.
Well, here it is, then. Here come another raggedy one. Here it is. Mother's Day is Sunday, and I wrote a poem to remind y'all why you should love your mama and spend some time with her and do something nice for your mama come this Sunday. This name of this poem, Mother's Day Poem. Here it is. Got a cold, can't sleep at night. Who is there to make it right? Your mama. Call her up when you're feeling down to help you get up your feelings off the ground. Who you gonna call? Your mama. She did without so you could have. She made you cry, she made you laugh. Who was that? Your mama. Spit on a napkin to get the spot. That's what mamas do. Have you forgot? Your mama.
What?
Make that meal that you love so well. She was right there when you had to go to jail. Who was that? Your mama.
Jail.
So mama, dear mama, this salute to you. For without all mamas, what the hell we gonna do? Your mama, the end.
Wow.
Woo. Wow. What's his name?
I
Come
can't
on,
take
Steve.
It.
Wow. What's his name again?
Can we go around the room?
J-Rap. Better known as Junior's Raggedy Ass Poem.
I can't take it.
Oh my God.
I can't take myself. I can't take it.
Happy Mother's Day?
Happy Mother's Day. Your mama.
Yeah. Your mama.
Your mama.
Yes. That's the that's the importance of the poem. Your mama.
I especially like the part about when you went to jail. I like that part.
You didn't even see that coming.
You covered it all. You covered it all.
I covered everything.
No, nobody saw that coming.
Yes.
Spitting on the napkin, though. I haven't forgot that, though. I have not.
You remember how she used to do that? Your mama.
It's been so long since we've heard a poem from you, Junior. I'm just saying.
Oh, it ain't been that long, Shirley.
I know.
Well, it seems like it.
Yeah. It was Easter, Shirley. Last one was Easter.
Just last month, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah, you must not be paying attention. They come.
I was really looking forward to his Mother's Day poem, though. I really was.
Junior, don't ever stop. Don't ever stop. I can't.
This is what the pandemic has did to me.
If you let hate stop you, you'll just stop. Don't let it stop you, Junior.
This is your purpose.
Yeah. So pandemic made you think you was a... It just...
A poet.
Well, did it make you... So what you want me to do? Stop it?
Okay. All right, well...
Ladies and gentlemen, J-Rap.
The shenanigans continue on this show. Coming up at the top of the hour, Comedy Roulette with Jay. We'll be back right after this.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
All right, it is time for Comedy Roulette, and Jay, can we just have a brief explanation?
Here's how it goes. Take three subjects, put them on a wheel, spun the wheel. Where it stops, we can make it funny. Put them up and spun it.
Here we go. Here goes the subjects right now. Ways women will tell you no, not tonight. Ways that women will tell you no, not tonight.
I didn't hear the last one of them. I didn't hear the last one of them.
Stupid questions that white people ask black people.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. And I grew up in a white neighborhood. I know all them, too. You know
And things a drunk person will blurt out. Okay? Those are the subjects.
Okay. All right.
All right. Let's spin it.
Put them up. Spin it.
What do you know? It's stupid questions that white people ask black people.
Here we go. Let's Comedy go, Roulette. Jay. Stupid questions that white people ask black people. Mm-hmm. Can I touch your hair? Can I touch your hair? Hell no, you can't touch my hair.
That's it.
Go ahead.
Stupid questions that white people ask black people. Is chicken really that good? Get your ass whooped.
I eat it too. Right now.
I'm just asking, is it? I mean, you guys have it every time.
Go ahead, Tommy.
Stupid questions that white people ask black people. So how do you know the watermelon's good?
What?
Come on, Steve. Stupid questions that white people ask black people.
Hey, did you know the black guy that robbed the liquor store last night?
Yeah.
What?
That hurts.
I don't see no hell that is.
Stupid questions that white people ask black people. Comedy Roulette. So you're in first class. What do you do?
That's it.
That happens all the time.
We've all been asked that. Yes.
I mean, I hear you guys talk about it all the time. So, how is government cheese? Is it like regular cheese, or is it just government cheese? Are they different?
Stupid questions. That white people ask black people, so are you serious? I mean, you really can't dance? Are you serious? You can't dance, dude?
Stupid questions that white people ask black people, Steve.
Hey, I hope I'm not, being intrusive, but is your dad around?
Oh, yeah.
What the hell you mean is my dad around?
Man.
Yeah, hell yeah, till he died, yeah.
Wow. Man.
Stupid questions that white people ask black people. How did you get a new car? How the hell did you get a new car?
It's nice, too. Put a compliment on the end, Jay. Yeah, stupid questions white people ask black people. So tell me, when did you meet Jay-Z?
The hell you think I know Jay-Z?
I don't know Jay-Z. You never said I knew Jay-Z?
Stupid questions that white people ask black people. So you mean you're not fast? You can't run? You're not fast at all? Oh my God.
All right, come on, Steve. Stupid questions that some white people ask black people.
Hey, are those your real lips?
Oh!
What?
You haven't had any injections.
You're just that size naturally. Yeah.
Yeah. Out the gate.
Go ahead, Jay.
Stupid questions that white people ask black people. The police are not hassling a lot of black people. Isn't that true? Really? Wouldn't you agree to that?
What?
Yeah.
Oh, stupid questions that
have white people ask black people, hey, I don't mean to bother you, but are your church services really this long? Because we've been here since 7. It's 2:30. I'm hungry.
I know.
Go ahead, Steve.
Last one. Stupid questions white people ask black people. Hey, why can't we use the N-word?
Whoa!
And that, ladies and gentlemen, is Comedy Roulette. We'll be back with more of the Steve Harvey Morning Show in 20 minutes after, right after this.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
All right, so here's a tribute to mothers all over the world. This Sunday is Mother's Day. Now, there was a woman in Africa. She'll likely set a Guinness World Record for delivering the most babies at one time. She's 25 years old. Her name is Halima Sisi. She gave birth to 9 babies on Tuesday. 5 girls, 4 boys. 9
what?
Children at one time. Yeah.
Oh, man.
Woo!
Uh-uh.
25 years
all
old.
All them ain't mine.
Uh-uh.
All them ain't mine. I'm going to go through and figure out which one's mine. All of them don't belong to me.
Yeah,
I like what her husband said, though. He said, God gave us these children. He is the one to decide what will happen to them. When the Almighty does something, he knows why. So, Steve, you have 7 children, you and Marjorie. What would you do if you had 9?
At one time?
At one time.
All these can't be my kids. I take 2 of them. I do 2. We're going to have to get some blood tests for the rest of them. I'm taking 2. That's all I got. There's no way in hell I'd have made 9 kids. I'm not doing it that good. I can tell you that right now.
The 2 short ones is mine. That's it.
You better know that's it. Yeah. And I got the ones with the big lips. Other than that, I don't know what you got.
Any of them light skinned, they can't be mine. I'm with y'all, man.
Yeah.
Woo! Happy Mother's Day. We'll have more of the Steve Harvey Morning Show coming up in 33 minutes.
I take the one that can play soccer and the one that play basketball.
They're babies. We'll be back with more 33 minutes after, right after this.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, it is time. I know you've been waiting. Mother's Day is this Sunday. Junior, step up to the mic and let us have it.
Yes, ladies and gentlemen, let me introduce to you. I've finally come up with the perfect name that fits him on Poetry Day. Ladies and gentlemen, J-Rap.
Thank you. Thank you. J-Rap is in the building. Thank y'all so much.
Somebody please ask me what J-Rap stands for.
What does that mean?
What does it stand for, Steve?
Junior's Raggedy Ass Poems.
All right, J-Rap.
Well, here it is, then. Here come another raggedy J-Rap. When you're right. Here it is. Mother's Day is Sunday, and I wrote a poem to remind y'all why you should love your mama and spend some time with her and do something nice for your mama come this Sunday. This name of this poem, Mother's Day Poem. Here it is. Got a cold? Can't sleep at night? Who is there to make it right? Your mama! Call her up when you're feeling down to help you get up your feelings off the ground. Who you gonna call? Your mama! She did without so you can have. She made you cry, she made you laugh. Who was that? Your mama! Spit on a napkin to get the spot. That's what mamas do. Have you forgot? Your mama!
What?
Make that meal that you love so well. She was right there when you had to go to jail. Who was that? Your mama.
Jail.
So mama, dear mama, this salute to you. For without all mamas, what the hell we gonna do? Your mama. The end.
Wow.
Woo. Wow.
What's his name? Come
I can't
on,
take
Steve.
It.
Wow. What's his name again?
Can we go around the room?
J-Rap. Yeah. Better known as Junior's Raggedy Ass Poems.
Oh my God!
I can't take
dude.
Myself. I can't take it.
Happy Mother's Day.
Happy
what?
Happy Mother's Day. Your mama.
Yeah. Your mama. Yes. That's the that's the importance of the poem. Your mama.
I especially like the part about when you went to jail. I like that part.
You didn't even see that coming.
You covered it all. You covered it all.
I covered everything.
No, nobody saw that coming.
Yeah. Spitting on the napkin, though. I haven't forgot that, though. I have not.
You remember how you used to do that? Your mama! Man.
It's been so long since we've heard a poem from you, Junior. I'm just
saying. Oh, it ain't been that long, Shirley.
I know.
Well, it seems like it.
It was Easter, Shirley. The last one was Easter. I know.
just last month, huh?
Yeah, yeah. You must not be paying attention. They come.
I was really looking forward to his Mother's Day poem, though. I really was.
Junior, don't ever stop. Don't ever stop. Keep doing what you're doing.
I can't.
Don't.
I can't. This is what the pandemic has did.
If you let hate stop you, you'll just stop. Don't let it stop you, Junior. Keep
doing. This is your purpose. Your purpose.
Yeah. So pandemic made you think you was a. It just.
A poet. What did it make you? So what you want to do? Stop.
Okay. Coming up, it is our last break of the day.
It is the last break of the day. Please register to vote, because they are not playing. The Republicans ain't playing.
And we'll have some closing remarks from the one and only Steve Harvey right after this.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
All right, guys, here we are, last break of the day. Before we get out of here, first of all, we want to say thank you to Anthony Hamilton, who was our special family member guest today.
Yeah.
All right? Make sure you check out his new song, You Made a Fool Out of Me. Yeah.
Woo! Download it now.
That was good. Fire, fire, fire. Yeah. And, of course, we want to say happy Mother's Day to all of the wonderful mothers, the grandmothers, stepmothers, guardians, godmothers, whoever you are.
Yes.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. And happy Mother's Day to you. We salute you all. Steve?
Hey, you know something? I've been watching these Republicans pass these voter suppression laws. Mm-hmm. I've watched them claim so falsely that the election was stolen. It is amazing the number of Republicans who actually are buying into that. Now, you know what? And the Republican senators and congressmen and people who are running for office are really just perpetrating this lie. This is really an amazing hoax. And I think that America is showing its true self with this. And not all, but there's a segment of this country that does not care how they win, just as long as they win. There is no moral ethics anymore. It's just, this is what we do to remain in power, and this is what we do. So they bought into this Donald Trump lie from the get-go that the election was stolen. How can you steal an election in 2021? How? How could you steal one in 2020? With all the technology that's out there, all the forensic scientists, all the data, all the Republicans that work in voter registration, with all the Democrats, how do you steal an entire election? How do you coordinate a massive fraud in so many states? And he's only complaining about the fraud in the states that he lost in. So there couldn't be voter fraud in Texas. There couldn't be fraud in Wyoming. There couldn't be fraud in the states that you Ohio. There couldn't be fraud in North Carolina, West Virginia, where you won. No, he's just claiming fraud in the states he lost in. The number of Republicans at over 70-some percent that actually think this election was stolen, they will even believe in a lie that they know isn't even possible. This country is in a sick and a sad state. I never thought that a president as bad as Donald Trump could linger on as long as he has in these people's minds. They are literally afraid of this man, and they think that his base is so strong that it'll help get them elected. I think this whole thing is gonna backfire. And like Jay was talking about earlier, we got to register to vote, because they are trying already to suppress the vote. But what they don't know is, and here's what they will never comprehend, they have awakened the sleeping giant. We are no longer this voting bloc that won't vote anymore. We are registering more and more and more and more people of color. We are registering more and more people that are on the blue side, more moderate, more liberal living people. We're just registering more people. Look, it's okay to be Republican. It really is. You need both of them to make this country work. It can't all be the way the Democrats want it. And it certainly can't be all the way the Republicans want it, because this world would be so unjust and unfair to too many of the people. And that's why we're supposed to have these free elections in this world. But now when one party claims the system that they created, This is the system that they created. All of a sudden, it's now an unjust system. Oh, my God. Simply because you lost? Well, now do you know that you've opened up the Pandora's box? Do you realize now that we can lay claim now that every election is stolen now, that every election is rigged? You can lay claim to that, which is going to invalidate the entire system that y'all created. But I have news for you. If you think you're going to suppress the black vote, if you think you're going to keep us away from the polls, I have news for you. We woke now. We woke now. We're not going back to sleep. You've awakened the sleeping giant. We saw that our vote changes elections. It was us who changed the elections, and you know it was us. And so now all of your laws and things right now are geared towards stopping us from voting. This is voter suppression. This is why we keep calling this country racist. Because you keep doing racist things because you keep enacting racist policies. That's what makes you racist. How you trying not to be called racist when that's what you do? Like that white lady told that Latino man, you'll never be white. He didn't say he wanted to be. And the lady was black and told the Mexican, you'll never be white. Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? What's wrong with us? So we've fallen, we drinking the Kool-Aid too. We drinking the same Kool-Aid they drinking. Man, this world right here, man, this is a fallen world. That's why, let me say something to y'all. Get into your faith and stay there. And put your faith in your Creator and your Heavenly Father. Whatever your faith is, put it there. Because these people, they going sideways, man. This country, man, is falling off the deep end by their own doing. The Republican Party will never be the same again. Politics in this country will never be the same again. But I tell you what, we will never not vote again. I'll tell you that. So we will be forever determining who's in office. And Kemp, when it comes time for the governorship of Georgia come around, you will not be governor again.
For all Steve Harvey contests, no purchase necessary, void where prohibited. Participants must be legal U.S. residents at least 18 years old unless otherwise stated. For complete contest rules, visit SteveHarveyFM.com. You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.